standing this morning. We're going to celebrate His goodness. We're going to worship the Lord. It's Pentecost Sunday. And we're going to go ahead. And somebody said, we're going to remember Pentecost. And I said, no, we are going to experience Pentecost today. Let's prepare our hearts and let's get into His presence this morning. Amen. We're going to start off with a couple of old time songs.
Well, it's real. It's real. I feel it in my head.
Lord, outpouring of His Spirit. And I'm just asking you this morning if you would join with us in worship wholeheartedly, entering into His presence. Because if you do that today, I pray you will be here changed in the way that you walk in. Amen. Father, now we come. Father, now we come. We don't come tomorrow to say, fill us tomorrow. Lord, we're not saying here today that we want your help next week. Lord, we're here saying that we are here right now, this time and today. And Lord, our cry is, Lord, let that same power which fell on that first day of Pentecost fall on this Pentecost Sunday in this church service today. Lord, we're believing you, Father, that to touch hearts and lives today in this room. We're believing you, Lord Jesus, that many shall be filled with the baptism of the Holy Spirit today in this service. We proclaim it, we speak it, we believe, Lord. And Lord, with anticipatory hearts, we now enter into worship. And we say, Lord, let us celebrate your goodness and your power today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And all of God's people said, amen. Let's worship the Lord today. Amen.
Oh,
shelter, out of the refuge of his wings. His holy presence. There's not a right way and a wrong way to worship him. He'll take your worship any way you offer it. It doesn't have to be like they worship. It doesn't have to be like I worship. It doesn't have to be like she worships. All he says is, I just want your worship. Last week, we mentioned to you from the book of Haggai, God said the silver is mine and the gold is mine. But the glory of the new house will be greater than that of the former. And what that means, my friend, is the old house, the old temple, was laden with jewels. It was laden with gold. It was one of the most beautiful things. It was one of the seven treasures of the ancient world. But God says that when my people come into my house, when my people come and they worship, it's more beautiful to me than all the silver and all the gold and all the diamond studded walls, because they sing a song the angels cannot sing, the song of the redeemed. And so I just encourage you as we worship for the next few moments, as we prepare our heart for the word, would you come and would you go to that secret place with us? Would you go into the shelter of the Most High God with us today? This place transformed by the Most High presence. Amen.
believe God's going to do some wonderful things in this house this morning. Before we transition to the word, though, I would like for us to go to the Lord in prayer. And I want us to take the opportunity that we have right now in his presence to bring our needs to him. Many of you have carried various things in with you. Why not just take them to the altar and leave them there today? There's other folks that are looking to us. Brother Jack is continuing to recover. He is out of the ICU. He's out of the hospital. And he is doing well. The family continues to ask for prayer and believing God for a complete and total recovery for him. Sister Margaret's going to be driving to Louisiana this afternoon. Grandma has gone home to be with Jesus. We're going to believe God for the presence of God to envelop that homegoing celebration, because that's what it is. It is a time to remember a race well run. And a prize earned. Hallelujah. And I don't know, would you just right now, would you just go with us to the Father in prayer? And Deacon Farrah, can I have you to just pray over the needs of the church, over the needs that we've mentioned, and whatever else the Lord lays on your heart this morning. Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you for the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it's all because of Jesus. And you know, we always like to hear from a prophet, because we believe that a prophet tells us, oh, you're going to have
Thank you for taking the time to watch this video of one of our services at Gateway of Hope Church. We hope that it has blessed you, and if it has, we would love to hear from you. You can contact us via our website at gatewayhouston.org, or connect with us on Facebook at facebook.com/gatewayhouston. Of course, you can always tell us in person. We would love to meet you. We meet together Sunday mornings at 9:45 a.m. for Sunday school, and at 11 a.m. for our morning worship celebration. We also have midweek encounter Wednesday nights at 7:30 p.m. More information about our church and our service times can be found at gatewayhouston.org. God bless you, and see you soon.